certain areas of this play that I want to talk about. You see, Act 1 and Act 2, let's first, very briefly state that this play is a tragedy. That is, the genre of this play is tragedy. And this is a modern tragedy. So we need to distinguish it from classical tragedy. So modern tragedy happens in among ordinary people, and this is a family. So, and the factors of modern tragedy, that is, the reasons of modern tragedy, are rooted in environment, in socio political culture, in individuality, and in different kind of conflicts, clashes between different institutions that modernity nurtures, but at the same time, the institutions that follow modernity, like ghosts of the past, and then there is a future as well. So modern tragedy happens at several levels. So first thing is that if we categorize this play as a genre, then this is a tragedy, okay, a modern tragedy. And number two is the play has a story. Briefly, if we state that story in a brief manner, it goes this way: the birth of a conjoined twin in an affluent family, and the family is an Indian Hindu family with its own belief structures and rituals, taboos that are inherited by the family. But on the top of the family is the layer of modern world, modern profession, and this family lives in India, particularly the southern part of India, Bangalore and Bombay. The play's flashback happens in Bombay, but Bangalore reference comes again and again. And the birth of conjoined twins leads to this is where the plot, the seed of the plot, is shown by the playwright, and then it develops. Now, what we see that in Act 1, if we look at Act 1, so what we see here that this play, the Act 1, Act 1 gives us, let us see if on this page, one phrase is complicated dynamics of modern urban family. this you can retain as a question. I mean, a question may be asked. Discuss Tara as a play that portrays complicated dynamics of modern urban family. So this question may be an essay type question. Okay, you can note it. Then characters struggle for some kind of freedom and happiness under the weight of tradition, cultural construction of gender, and repressed desire. These four words are important: tradition, cultural construction of gender, and repressed desire. That you can put aside for question. Now, this invisible issues of Indian society, this is again important area for the essay type question. So by pulling taboo subjects out from under the rug, placing them on stage for public discussion, and then Tara centers the emotional separation that grows between two conjoined. So separation is a important theme here. And then you go on. So this is from the introductory part, and then a multi-level set, if we come to here. Now, those of you who have studied it know that multi-level set here means the play, if you notice in Act 1 or Act 2, the play shifts. There is a very brilliant use of light design, because the stage is one place. So again and again, you have the word spot on. Spot on is a technical term in theater design. And the light will fall on certain character or follow the certain character. So whenever the phrase spot on occurs in this text, you try to imagine that the light designer has to put or throw light onto those areas. So if we see in Act 1, visualize the multi-level set, we see one is Dan and Dr. Khattar. So Dan and Dr. Khattar, this is one combination. And another is the family space, the house where the history or the memory will be recreated through the action. So memory will be recreated through the action. So that is another area where light is to fall. One is the street. Street is a place which is between this home and other neighbors. Particularly, you must have noticed three girls who talk about this family. One of them becomes a friend, and then sometimes Tara or Chandan accompanies them, and in the street some dialogue happens. So street is one important area. So street, home, then Dan, and then there is a shifting of the light. So cross cuts. So that is, you know, a very interesting design in this in this play, a cross cut or something like this. So when few stories go parallelly, so you notice that this play actually in act one throughout we see stories go parallelly, but you have, you know, shifting or a kind of collage. Focus or the light is on sometimes in the family area where memory is being recreated, or sometimes it is on Dan and Khattar where the script is being written. So one is that the script for the play is in progress. At the same time, the performance is happening on the stage. So what we notice is that the play is not just a script, but both performance and script are taking shape in the process of performance itself. So what we notice in act one is that this very act of both creating what should be played and remembering or manifesting what has been played. So what should be played and what has been played, the two voices are in conflict, in love, in harmony, in discordance, in disharmony, you know, different kinds of things take place. So this you should notice, that the strategy or the design, Mahesh Dattani's design of writing, of crafting, I should say crafting, because yesterday I wrote that W-R-I-G-H-T, this is different from W-R-I-T-E. So W-R-I-T-E is act of writing, but W-R-I-G-H-T is act of crafting. Crafting goes closer to artisan. So the word W-R-I-G-H-T is from artisan and the culture of artisan, or making something. W-R-I-T-E is not from artisan, but a mere mental act expressed in language. So there is a huge difference. That is why W-R-I-G-H-T, this write, is so dominant in the entire play. In act one, we very clearly see that two things are happening at the same time. And now, what is happening in the family, of course, is history. It happened. And then Dan now is sitting in UK. So there is a distance between the two. So on the stage, you really don't have the distance, but distance is a metaphor there, and that metaphor would be represented by light, or by light design basically, and set design. So set design can reflect that distance, and light design can reflect that distance. And at the same time, third thing is the sound design. Sound can also reflect that distance. So, and particularly these three areas. Okay, costume may not, but these three things can help a lot in creating that distance, physical distance, that is the geographical distance, and then the difference of time. Difference of time, there are two important things, time and space. So both of these are created by using different kind of devices. Now what happens here in The lowest level occupies a major portion of the stage, okay, and it represents the house of the Patels. It is seen only in memory and may be kept as stark as possible. And next level represents the best bedsitter of Alder Chandan, referred to Dan for clarity in a subject of London. And then behind on higher is Dr. Tucker, remains seated throughout the play. Although, so this is how, you know, it begins. Now, now Dan starts speaking. Now you notice that what Dan speaks in the beginning seems to give us an idea that his speech has ended. Actually, his speech continues throughout the play. So this is important that Dan as a writer starts the play and ends the play and he reappears again and again. And so this strategy we must understand. Now, what we notice here, one is Dan is to develop this. At the same time, he is also interviewing Dr. Tucker. So that now Dr. Tucker is the voice of clinical. It's a clinical voice. I wouldn't say medical science, but clinical, because he is a practitioner. He's a surgeon, and he actually separated the two from one. So and then, of course, he talks in a very precise manner about the diligence involved in the operation, the problem, then hypothesis, then observation, then rehearsal. Rehearsals also took place to create this. I mean, before they reached to the real operation, they rehearsed, and they found that most of the that they did not want to take any risk, because the risk would have really been fatal. And then the play goes on. As soon as Dan finishes his speech, the light is on the home, the family, the Patels, where we come to know that they have shifted from Bangalore to Bombay. And Patel works in a very high profile company and is in very senior position. And we come to know that Patel and Bharti, they married against the will of their parents. It's an interstate marriage also, like Gujarat, and he is a Gujarati, and Bharti is from Bangalore, from Karnataka, and she comes from a family of powerful background. Her father was a politician, also an MLA, and was influential in many ways, also very rich. So that that reference in Act One, we come to know, we see that that has a lot of impact in the play. And now so this is how things go. Now the focus, the light may shift to Dan and then proceeds further, for example. So it's a kind of zigzag, no linearity. So the play's development breaks the idea of linearity and realism. So this we should have a word now, that the non-linear dramatic progress, the non-linear dramatic progress, shifting between time and spaces, at the same time the story growing up. You see, Act 1, you see, there are certain things that are referred there. Dan says, I have forgotten, I had a twin sister. Now, until I thought of her as subject matter for next literary attempt, or maybe I didn't forget her, she was lying deep inside, out of reach. Okay. And a spot on, this is again that light reference. Chandan and Tara walk into, they both have a limp, but on a different leg. And inseparable, the way we started in life, two lives and one body. This is important, two lives and one body. So now, you see, this is also allegorical. Allegorical, like there are many Hindi films that will use it, though two lives in one body, though dil ek jaan, or something like that. So again and again, you know, they also laugh at so many things. So Act One does not have only darkness of the story, but there are ironies, there are laughter, satire, jokes, all kinds of those things are there. So we need to notice that. Now this allegory, that is the there are a number of Hindi films that have told us the story of two brothers or two sisters, or a brother or a sister separated in a mela. ये दो भाई थे मेले में गुम हो गए, एंड पूरी फिल्म चलते चलते उसके बाद में लास्ट में उनके अंदर कुछ मिला, बनियान या कुछ यहाँ पर बाजू पे या अंदर कुछ एक स्पॉट मिल गया, दाग मिला, और माँ ने पहचान लिया और दोनों का मिलन हो गया. नाउ दिस प्ले इन ए वे सेटराइजेज दैट काइंड ऑफ पॉपुलर इंडियन फिल्म प्लॉट. दिस एक्चुअली ये जो भाई बहन है वो मेले में नहीं सेपरेट हुए, उनको सर्जरी से सेपरेट किया गया. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. व्हेन आई से कि दो भाई बहन को सर्जरी से सेपरेट किया गया, दो दिल एक जान को सर्जरी से सेपरेट किया गया, और मेले में डाकू आए थे और डाकुओं के कारण वो गुम नहीं हुए थे. नाउ दिस इज नो द एलिगोरिकल एस्पेक्ट that has references in the text. So none of the things I will talk will be only figment of my imagination. I will substantiate that from the text that I have quoted. And now the play begins here, a game of card. So I'm just giving you some clue. For example, a game of card. Mother is in puja. Okay, and then father briefcase, and then you see the three things are there: card, play of card, puja, and briefcase. Now this briefcase will remain briefcase. Okay, throughout this briefcase. Now in a play, objects on the stage are not accessories or are not just properties. What is our understanding of properties or accessories in a play must be very clear. They are integrally woven into the very idea of the play. So let us not say a briefcase is a briefcase. No. Or let us not say a play of card is a play of card. Or let us not say a puja is a puja. And later we come to know there are few more things that happen. So if I make a list of the objects that are in this play, they will tell the story. They will reveal a lot of dramatic action. So now you see, game of cards, okay? The pack of cards, puja, briefcase, and peristatalis, and then milk. There is a reference to milk again and again. Okay, then certain cassette, video cassette, VCR cassette. Then objects, there are other objects also. So the objects of a performance script are not meant for accessory. That is, they must be given to characters to give them a character must, if somebody is working in a multinational company, corporate house, and is a senior manager, so should have a briefcase. And not like that. There could have been a lot of other things. So briefcase and all of these objects will have their dramatic function. For example, the play of card. What is the dramatic function of the game of card? In the very beginning, when we are introduced to Tara and Chandan, they are playing cards. And cards are giving them a space to dialogue. Okay, who is more intelligent? And then they are laughing. Now, I also see this presence of the card in the very beginning. On one hand, Dan is writing this story, writing the play. On the other hand, we are when Tara and Chandan get the focus. So this card or shuffling. So the metaphor of the play card is a shuffling of the life. We will see that on the stage, even different multi-level set is also shuffling and reshuffling of the play Tara. So the metaphor, that play of card is not just, the set of cards is not just a set of cards, but it is a great metaphor. It's a very important dramatic metaphor that this, that the life of these four people is being shuffled and reshuffled. And who wins the game and who loses the game, then there are a lot of other people outside. One is Dr. Thakkar. So Dr. Thakkar sitting there is also a metaphor. A metaphor of what? Okay? One who is the two doctors we have, Dr. Thakkar and Dr. Kapoor in Act 1. So both of these doctors come from a certain community whose nearest forefathers were in business, particularly grain or purchase or sale or something like that. Kapoor and Thakkar, both of them come from the Indian caste who had nothing to do with healing or medical practice or in the past, recent past. Okay. So what we see that the presence of these two doctors suggests a layer, one layer of Indian society where mobility of people from upper caste to new profession, whether engineering or medical. So when the Britishers, you see, otherwise, though both of these professions, engineering, for example, in India, engineering means, let us say, blacksmith or goldsmith or carpenters, all of these people were engineers otherwise in the past. So when modernity arrived and engineering and medical, these areas emerged as the most promising because there was a lot of possibility of mobility. Mobility means one could move from nation to nation. That is what we notice in Dr. Thakkar. So Dr. Thakkar is a foreign returned and then he settled somewhere else and he is, you know, there between Europe or the Western world and India. So that kind of shifting is there. So although in this entire play, it's very difficult to see the role of caste, but we must see that there are two, three important areas. One is the medical practitioners here, whose caste or forefathers were not in medical practice or Ayurveda or any kind of healing practice. Number two, the reference to milk, a Patel.